Okay, so now we have Q&A station.
Yes.
Well, we have Q&A. I think we have like minus 3 minutes. Is that right? But hopefully we can ask a few questions in minus 3 minutes if people have them. Andreas had a question. Does it search workflows with BDF? Cookie. I don't know if you answered that in the talk, but does the global search work also for PDF?
No, this is currently only working for writer documents, not even all the supported documents inside Collaborum. This was the first goal.
Makes sense.
And how far you will go with this search? I think it's a bit for a client, isn't it?
NLNet, yes. So I think at the moment we've completed the work for NLNet. It would be nice to have someone that wanted more work here so that we could make it work beautifully. But I think it's a very unique thing to be able to search inside and have a graphical view of what you've hit. I'm pretty pleased by it. But having more people that wanted beautiful search results would be good from customer perspective. So at the moment, Quickie is working on other things, I think. Some other gorgeous, important thing. So, there's lots of things that need doing. You know, we live in a candy store, and the only shortage is money.
We also have another question for you, Andreas, from Ash. He asks, the files were in JS, but the content was in JSON. Does JS imply there could be JavaScript code or just JSON? Feel free to answer in the Q&A. Yes.
Yeah, I think it's both. So you can mix. And you also have some commands with HTML link and so on. So I think you can mix. And you have these two notebook bar and notebook bar builder files that are in general the generator stuff. And in the writer, calc and so on, notebook bar files, you have the content. So I think you can mix, but I think most stuff is in this builder's files. But it's really easy and you don't need anything. In general, you only have to add the YUML command and that's it.
The reason I'm asking you...
It's way cooler than in LibreOffice. Sorry.
No, I hear you. Keep it simple. So it's just that sometimes you need a bit of dynamic logic maybe or to calculate something at runtime. That's what I was trying to see if it was possible or not.
For example, the font selector. You only add the command and the font selector. I don't know where it comes from, but it's the same than the toolbar font selector. So you don't have to do anything, yes.
Right. Makes sense. Thank you.
Welcome.
You are muted, Michael, but you are talking a lot, it seems.
That's the reason why you're muted.
Yeah, the smarts are connected to them at a different level, the JavaScript. And the plan, I think, was to get this into LibreOffice as well, so it was easier to edit toolbars there. We've been busy. Perhaps you noticed. Good. Any other questions?
It seems like the Martimos team is eager to listen to the Martimos presentation, so they will retweet someone now, I think. So they would bring some additional people.
Well, there's a lot of cool talks going to come up shortly around integration. So yeah, do bring your friends, as it were. I'm sure we move on then.